Hi there, my name is Beth, and I am trying to show you in this lousy video how to use the Fred Sheet, which is a Google Sheet that you can use to coordinate and manage your Fred metabolism items for your Red M server. I am not a great video maker, and nor am I a good trainer, so I'm hoping that this video helps people. If it is unclear, let me know and I will redo it again. So first thing you can do is go to Fredsheet 2.0. I'll post the URL underneath somewhere here, and make yourself a copy. File, make a copy, and name it so you'll know what it is. I'm gonna leave mine as it is, and I'm gonna make a copy. So that copy will be a new copy. It'll be fresh and clean, and I'll be able to edit it. For the moment, I'm going to ignore these instructions because I believe they need updating. But the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to export all the consumable items from your database. I'm using Heidi SQL, which I'm assuming most of you are. And this is my entire database. For ease of Fred export, we have prefaced every consumable item with the prefix Fred underscore, and that is because we know how hard it is to find them otherwise, and to export them out. There's other options you could do as well. In my previous county, I had added a column to the database which was Fred include, and it was a Boolean true or false, and we could query on that. I decided not to mess with the structure of the database this time and use this methodology. I think it's a good one. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to find all your items however you can find them. If you want to preface them, that's fine. If you want to if you've already got them going, you might not want to do that. You might want to add a field, and you can do that fairly easy here by adding a column at your table. You can just add a column called like Fred, and then you can make it a bit, so 0 or 1. I'm not going to save that because again I don't want to alter the structure of my database, but you could do that if you've already got your names and you don't want to have to redo them because of crafting recipes or whatever. So what I'm going to do though is I'm going to do this item like Fred filter. I'm going to apply the filter, and that'll give me all of the items that I have created for my brand new county that I want to be consumable. So getting these out is very simple. You just right click on any row, choose export grid rows, copy to clipboard, Excel format, the complete selection of them. I include column names. I figure it's easier. I just leave the defaults, to be honest with you. But mostly what you need is complete and Excel. That's really what you need. And once you click OK, that's copied to your clipboard. Even if you have a large amount of items, it should be fine. It's a pretty small amount of data. You're going to go back to your copy of Fred Sheet, and you're going to go to the Export Paste tab. And you're going to click on the item header, because we did copy the headers over, and you're going to just right click and paste. And there you've got all of your items that you pasted in. And you'll see it brought all the data over. You don't need most of that data, basically what it's looking for is the item and the label for the most part. Important that you don't change data in this field over here. This field is the field that you will use to know which items are new. And I'll explain that in a minute. So right now, all of my items are new because this is a brand new spreadsheet. It's a brand new spreadsheet. So anything with NA in this column is something that needs to get added to my Fred metabolism. This filter is already preset to NA for you, but I did expose it in case you need it. I had it hidden, but I think it might be easier to have it exposed for people. So anything that is a value of NA here means that it is not in this next spreadsheet. So the reason why it says NA is because it's not over here, and it's doing a lookup of for this name on this spreadsheet. So then anything that is NA, you're going to highlight, and you're going to take over these two columns, the label and the item. And you're going to drop it into the Fred metabolism sheet. And you'll see here this number auto-populates. It's looking up to see if this item is in this spreadsheet. And that is the actual ID of the item that was exported from the database. So now I've got all the familiar fields from Fred metabolism that we well No. And we're just going to go through. I mean, obviously, a carrot is not make you very full, but I think, a box tea is something that probably makes you more full. And you'd just go through and you'd add your, how full this is going to make you, how much of your health bar it's going to. I mean, I'm not really taking too much time, but basically you're going to fill up all these values, how long you want it to do the gold, the hunger gold, how long thirst, how much thirst, how much thirst gold. Obviously a carrot is probably not going to, none of these things are going to do. I might like to include a booze, so I'm going to go down to my Guinness Stout. I'm going to give it a, I don't know, Guinness Stout quenched your thirst pretty good, right? No hunger gold, but maybe, thirst gold, and maybe it's kind of fattening. Maybe it's more fattening than other things. Irish stew would definitely be fattening, right? Coddle, I'm not even sure how fattening that would be. Fish and chips, definitely fattening. White pudding, gross. It's like a suet-based sausage. So let's go, I don't know, 200. But anyway, you know these fields. You know what they are. Metabolism maybe 10 for a carrot. But fill them all up. Alcohol. Alcohol in Fred now is percentage, I believe, up to 100. So a Guinness Stout, probably take five of them. I want everybody to get drunk, so I'm going to make it four of them make you drunk. Definitely reduces stress when you drink your alcohol. Again, I think anything over 100 in Fred is stressed. So we could make it so that certain foods like dessert, dessert reduce your stress, and Guinness Stout reduces your stress by 25. So that is that's what alcohol's for, right? And then you've got all this, your familiar fields, staminas, and your gold cores. And those are all, values that we're familiar with. I believe that the cores are how long, the golds are how long it will stay gold, and not a percentage. So here's the fun part. I've built for you a drop-down list of all of the different items that the animations that you can use in Fred, from eat to sniff. And then I've built you a drop-down list of a set of some of the of possible props. There are thousands of them in Mushi, but in this case, it's carrots. You're going to eat a carrot. And then this should probably not have an effect because it doesn't make you drunk. So I got to get rid of duration as well. And then you're not going to get, this is the return item name and the return item quantity. I was obviously testing some things with the new Fred. So for example, we're going to go back down to my Guinness. Obviously, I would fill out all of these for all of these items. But for Guinness, I probably am going to choose to drink, and I'm going to pick a bottle of some sort. I'm going to pick a bottle of, well, let's do something creative. So while I have a list of options for you to pick from here, I've put a bunch of props in. You can actually put any prop you want in there. And the way you do that is you just go to Mushi, and you could put in beer. You could put in, ah, there we go. I like that one. I like this bottle. Looks kind of gray though. Maybe I'll pick this one. So I'm going to pick this bottle here. I'm going to go back to my spreadsheet. I'm just going to paste it where my Guinness Stout would be. Obviously, you want to get drunk. So I'm going to make people drunk, and I'm going to make them drunk for 10 seconds. I'm not going to give them a return item, but I could if I wanted to, and here's how many. And you could give them a return item with metadata here. I have not done metadata yet, so I might need to try that out and update this spreadsheet and make sure it works properly. Yeah, I think I probably need to. Anyway, once you do that for all your items, then you've got a really short way and a safe way to make all of your Lua code for that. All of your JSON tables will be created with this column here. So basically, if you go down to the bottom and you highlight your way up, and then you copy Control C, and you can go to your Fred Metabolism Lua items file. And you can get rid of all your items. I do them all at once every time so that I know that everything is perfect. And you get rid of all your items. You can paste those in, and everything will be perfect. Let's see if we can find our Guinness Stout so we can show off our effect. There he is. I saw him. Yep. So he's going to drink a bottle of beer. He's going to get drunk for 10 seconds. So basically, it creates all of the Lua for you. And that's basically how it works. There's a couple of gotchas that probably good to know. So let's say I want to use my